Many people believe that the only key to success is hard work. Thus, at the beginning of the year, they make resolutions and attempt to work hard. But after a period, they give up and waste the rest of the year. Indeed, there is no success without hard work, but there are other factors that can deter you from making progress. In this video, I will show you 9 reasons why you are not making progress year after year. 1. You don't have a plan. Among life's complicated axioms, there's one which should be taken literally. If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. Having goals without making our plans is just like deciding to travel to a foreign land without making preparations for transportation logistics. Even though you are sure of your destination, it is impossible to get there. Many people dream big dreams, set incredible goals, but fail to put strategies in place to fulfill that ambition. You do not have to have it all figured out. In fact, as you journey, there is a likelihood that your plans will change. But you must at least put something in place first. Else you'll find yourself either lost or following people around to just anywhere. You can't just live your life, year after year, having big dreams yet not making any plans. If you must progress, then you must make plans now. 2. You are still scared of failure. The fear of failure is one of the biggest reasons for stagnation. Many individuals remain in the same position year after year, not because they do not have plans, but because they have refused to take actions, because they are scared of failing. If you want to make a difference in your life, you must start working towards your goal. Contrary to your thoughts, if you fail at something, it does not mean that you are not good enough. Instead, consider it that you've just discovered a way that does not work. Pick up yourself and try another pattern. In the words of the founder, CEO and chairman of FedEx, Frederick Smith, the fear of failure should never be the reason not to try something. 3. You still set the same unrealistic goals. One of the qualities of a smart goal is that it must be realistic. At the beginning of the year, a lot of individuals become so pumped up that they set for themselves resolutions that are unrealizable. Often, after the first few weeks, 1 month maximum, they feel so pressured and end up giving up altogether. Thoughts of why did I not work harder, or maybe I should have worked on so-and-so a little more during the week, or wow, start creeping into our heads, and if not properly handled, you may carry the defeated mindset throughout the year. Even though your overall dreams seem almost impossible, by setting realistic goals and breaking them into schedules, you will ultimately progress. 4. You procrastinate. Procrastination is a thief of time, a grave where dreams and aspirations are buried. Well, that is no new knowledge to you. Many people know the adverse effects of pushing things forward, but they still find themselves doing it. They live with a stubborn illusion that we will always have tomorrow to do today's work, thus consistently procrastinating until work becomes a heavy burden. Those little tasks you procrastinate every day are not as small and irrelevant as you think they are. Those tasks, when summed together at the end of the year, are the goals and visions you had for the year. Procrastination is a habit that can only be stopped by taking a conscious step. And one beneficial step you can take is doing things immediately the need arises for them to be done. If you must make progress, you must be aware of how often you use the statement, "I will," and reduce it, and if possible, wipe it off totally. 5. You have not tried a new way. When you keep doing something the way you have always done it, you will continue to get the same result. If you want to move forward, you should stop doing things the way you ever did it and look for new methods. Let your mind be open and flexible enough to accept and attempt new ideas. For instance, if dieting alone does not help you burn calories, why not add exercise into it? If your business is not growing on Facebook as expected, why not try Instagram? The only harm in trying is giving up at the slightest difficulty. It's never too late to start. You can still move forward this year. So, explore. 6. You are not in the right company. It was the motivational speaker Jim Rohn who affirmed that every individual is the average of the 5 people they spend their time with. Scientific studies which have been carried out have backed up Jim Rohn's saying and concluded that humans are even more affected by the environment than they know. Many people like to claim that others cannot influence them, but whether you know it or not, or you agree with it or not, your personality and outcome in life are greatly influenced by the people around you, either consciously or subtly. If the people around you are not progressing, then you better search no further for the reason of your stagnancy in life. The reason is your company. Surround yourself with successful people. People who can motivate you when you are at the verge of giving up, who can lift you when you are falling, and who care enough to reprove you when you are going astray. 7. You have misplaced priorities. In his book, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, Stephen Covey noticed that one attitude that is common among unproductive people is that they spend time doing the things that are urgent, while they ignore the important ones. Note that priority in this context concerns timing. Most times, the inability to get your preferences straight is the reason why you are where you are. It is not like you do not have a goal or a strategy, but your priorities are misplaced, and so your goal is not in line with the present time. One way to be productive in life is to do first things first. Many people focus on doing the right thing but ignore the timing. Although doing the right thing should be of great concern to you, carrying out that task at the right time should be your goal. Because when you do the right thing at the wrong time, your result is either negative or neutral. If you want to progress as years go by, don't only do the right thing, do it at the right time. 8. You don't measure your progress in a granular form. One primary reason why it seems like you are not making progress is that you have not yet developed a measurement scheme for your short and long-term goals. An essential quality of a SMART goal is that it is measurable. Thus, before you begin a task, always ask yourself, is it measurable? If it is not, further ask, how do I make it measurable? And if it is a measurable goal, the next question is, what measurement strategy do I apply? For you to know whether or not you are moving towards your big goals, you must measure your activities. It sets you up on a positive momentum train. You can qualify your goals on a daily, weekly, and even monthly basis. However, your measurement must be quantifiable. For instance, if your goal is to lose some pounds, then you can purchase a weight scale and measure your weight in percentage, weekly. If you do not measure your goals, you will remain stagnant. 9. You are waiting for the right time. One excuse that most people give when they are asked why they are not yet started is, "I am waiting for the right time." American author Napoleon Hill once wrote, "Do not wait. The time will never be just right." Start where you stand and work with whatever tools you may have at your command, and better tools will be found as you go along. Many people are living their entire lives without ever standing up and stepping out. They are probably waiting for an invisible being to come whisper into their ears, "You can now do it." Studies consistently show that when we look back on our lives, the most common regrets are not the risk we took, but the ones we did not take. Even though most people do not admit it, the main reason behind their "I am waiting for the right time" excuse is fear. They are scared of the unknown. But if you allow yourself to be brainwashed into thinking that the reason for your not taking action is because it is not yet the perfect time, you will remain stagnant year after year. Stop waiting for the right time. There is no such thing as that. All you have is now, and you ought to fight that fear that holds you back and use your now wisely. If you want to see results in your life, then you must begin to notice the above pitfalls in your life and cover them.